Doncic.
Fuck. Never a fun time fighting this guy.
Ready? You ready to fight?
All right, so here we go. Round one is underway. Very compelling matchup for fight fans around the world. It's going to be very interesting to see.
I hate knees, bro.
The grappler goes for the takedown.
Well, he's going to try to get the takedown right away. But when he shoots that shot, when he changes that level, he is going to be shooting into a guy that truly understands all aspects of mixed martial arts. I'm wondering how, if his first shot doesn't work, does he approach trying to get this fight to the ground?
Oh, he did a great job of rotating it into an underhook.
And those knees aren't just for effect. Those are doing real damage. Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by this gentleman.
And that one was heavy. Oh, big left. Well, eventually, you know he's going to turn this defense into offense, but he's certainly doing a nice job on the defensive end.
They talk about the feeling out process. He's getting his opponent's timing. Now he's blocking everything. Expect counters as we go forward.
Single collar tie now. And he landed the right hand there. And he comes through with a big knee. Advantage, and you saw it right there with that punch. Jones gets caught with that punch.
He's back in the clinch. Watch for the knees to start to come out.
Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there.
People have been really spamming the tie.
Big knee lands there.
That knee hurt him.
Under 2 minutes now to go in round one. All right, so a good job defensively by him here as he raises the guard and prevents any damage.
Shades of James Toney. Always seeing things coming at him. He's such a great defensive fighter.
Uppercut lands now. So just over 20 total strikes have already landed for Stipe Miocic. Oh, single collar tie here. And they separate. Misses with that punch. Oh, and what a beautiful reaction by him there. DC caught the kick and immediately countered with a perfectly timed takedown.
I mean, John, when you can have a reactionary takedown, it's usually the easiest one because you don't have to go and find the takedown. You just see something, you counter and react on it, and it makes the takedown much easier.
Final seconds of round one. Oh, nice job here staying busy off of his back. Nice offense from the bottom.
Yeah, he's going to be spamming the tie.
All right, DC, second round is getting underway. Round one, not the round of the year necessarily, but some good in there.
And it's not always going to be. When you have two very talented fighters, sometimes it's very even. That's what we saw in round number one.
Trying to...
That was meant to be an uppercut. I can't move.
There's a takedown attempt there, DC. I'm no analyst, but that one was pretty telegraphed, not his best effort.
Yes, he may as well have sent
his guard was way up high, and he still stopped the takedown.
Shoot the moment the fight starts. Of course,
that was meant to be an uppercut as well.
Your attack, young man.
So 39 total strikes have landed for John Jones. Oh! Oh, he lands a huge knee to the back.
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. Chase that finish down now.
So holding on to him here, not doing a ton.
Come on.
Just looking to recover. Oh, big left hook there. All right, so he's landed some good shots. You hate to be overly critical, but nothing really in terms of combinations tonight.
Well, the jabber looked great. How about jab, jab, right hand? Because eventually you're going to have to put something on your opponent.
Oh, right under the elbow. Right under the roof.
Perfect.
pressure being applied here. Miocic is trying for the Kimura submission here.
Oh, now he's in trouble. Now he falls back into the finishing position.
Brilliant submission defense there.
Full side control now.
Miocic gets back up. That shot blocked by Jones. Here he is back in the clinch. Oh, magic!
Oh!
Well, a really good second round for him thus far. After a somewhat lackluster first round, he has found the rhythm and found...
Oh, that was a big takedown. Is this the one that's gonna break him?
Under a minute now to go in the round. A lot of top pressure being applied here as he works out of side control. Now he's able to isolate that left arm.
Look for him to step over the top of the head to lift his opponent onto his hip to chase his finish. The Kimura is not the arm. It's the shoulder pressure that usually makes you tap.
But now DC trying to isolate an arm.
Yep, he's using the Kimura.
And this might just be a matter of time.
Yo, he got saved by the bell. He got saved by the bell.
Just as the horn sounded, safe to say he was saved by the bell there. So, back to the stools.
This guy is spamming the tie clinch. I knew, like, that's been the meta for a little bit now, I've realized.
The adjustments are going to be the key, John. When you're doing everything you're training to, and it stays this close, you got to really switch it up.
Stuffs the takedown there. How good is his takedown defense? Oh, a little single collar tie there. And they separate.
And now please stop doing this, bro. Oh my God.
Mission accomplished. It does not get much better than that.
53 total strikes have landed for Johnny Bones Jones. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom. It's not the arm, it's the shoulder pressure that usually makes you tap. He actually goes to an omoplata. Great pressure going forward by the top five.
Not tapping out tonight. All right, right into side control here, DC. Biggest difference between half guard. Oh, looks like he's trying to isolate an arm, maybe set up a Kimura here, DC.
Yeah, he's going to try to attack a Kimura here. He'll try to get him up on his right hip. The Kimura is not the arm, it's the shoulder pressure that usually makes you tap.
But now DC trying to isolate an arm.
Yep, he's using the Kimura.
And this might just be a matter of time. The sheer will is really remarkable to watch. All right, full guard now, DC.
The fighter on top needs to be trying to gain posture to throw ground and pound and then move to the next position. But if you're on the bottom, you've got to build a shield to try to push your opponent off to try to get back to your feet.
All right, so the strike lands, but my children hit hard.
Yeah, at this
nice liver shot lands. Beautiful knee. Big knee to the body. Slips. All right, he engages. Big knee.
This guy plays like a bitch. Yeah, this guy plays like a total bitch.
So inside the open guard of his opponent, you gotta be careful playing around for too long here on the ground with this guy. 30 seconds now to go in the round.
Okay. 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 I'm pressing buttons to stand there. Okay. This guy just spammed the clinch all fight, bro. absolutely spam the clinch.
That is going to endear you to UFC President Dana White, to the matchmakers.
Whatever, man. It's part of the game. It is what it is, but I don't like how that's the meta now.
A huge shot landed clean. Clearly, his opponent was hurt very badly, and ultimately, the finish came right then and there. Outstanding execution down the stretch. Well, let's get you some replays now. Certainly a lot for our replay guys to work with. Now we go inside the octagon.
The whole fight was just Muay Thai clinch. He was spamming the absolute Jesus out of that. And I can't do that, because every time I try to do it and I get hit while I'm going to do it, it cancels. I don't know how it went for him in this fight. I honestly don't even remember. I was just trying to avoid this shit, but it seemed unavoidable. Like this, if I go away from range, if I fight outside, I'm in his wheelhouse. It's John Jones. I need to get in close. So if I get in close, he initiates the tie. And every time he'd bring me to the fence, and then it would just be like, oh, you want to get out? Too bad. You have to take fucking knees to the body first. And it was just, he got saved by the bell because I had that Kimura locked in. Like it was over for him. That's just annoying. It's really annoying how that's the meta. If anyone who plays UFC 4 is watching this, y'all know what I'm talking about. How body, knees, and elbows are the meta again. And it's not fun. It's really not fun fighting a TIE fighter like that. Yeah, I was afraid to come back on this game today, and that's exactly why, because people know that it's the meta now. So I'll post this, but yeah, thanks for watching, if anyone watches. But that was painful. See ya.